Intensity. Excitement. Cutthroat. Three words that accurately describe the Western Conference. I am expecting plenty of fights to the death throughout the season. As the year and endless charges through no man's land commence, what will these teams be looking forward to? After last year's embarrassing defeat in the playoffs, the time had come for much-needed changes to organizational philosophy. The team needed to get younger and faster. Anaheim's response to such humiliation is to be just as slow. Really? This is your answer to that old defense? Fat Shin and Andre Schuster? Some random guys at bottom six depth? Are you even trying anymore? It honestly seems like you aren't. You're just gonna rely on that core to bail you out and take you to the playoffs. Oh right, Corey Perry's in the infirmary for a while. Pray John Gibson stands on his head for, 4 months. For the love of God, can you fuckers do something this year? Please get the fuck out of the basement and make yourselves into a respectable team. Look, you brought in the much maligned Alex Galchenyuk, you took on more dead money from the Blackhawks, John Chyka is still the darling of internet forums everywhere. Your organization is a joke and has been for a long time now. Auntie Ranta and a winning season can get people like me to shut the fuck up. And then you'll probably move to Houston and allow them to experience the fruits of your success. Sorry, Glendale. As the team tries to strong-arm the city of Calgary into a new stadium, the Flames themselves are attempting to clear the creosote from their roster and make it back to the playoffs. What is the answer to their brutal inconsistency? Why, by taking in a bunch of Carolina Hurricanes, that's the cure for underachieving. Their old head coach, Noah Hanifin, Elias Lindholm, Derek Ryan, oh yeah, you got James Neal too. The plan seems to be barraging the net with more high-end talent, yet half-assing everything in their own. They're just praying to the holiest of gods that an aging Mike Smith keeps defying life with no backup option in sight. We saw how this played out last year, guys. You trying to conscript Naheed Nenshi for a stint there? Stepping into this team's halls is like going to a museum. There's a lot of old shit with a few new exhibits to try and freshen everything up. A fossilized Chris Kunitz, Philadelphia's whipping boy Brandon Manning, and a Cam Ward with a bunch of holes in it. The only hope for the Blackhawks is not in their young forwards like Schmaltz and DeBrincat, but by making a deal with the devil so that Corey Crawford manages to stay healthy this season. Vertigo is a fucking bitch, and there are instances where it lingers for an indiscriminate amount of time. You don't want to rely on Cam Ward for a season. Carolina will warn you on that one. As I had mentioned last season, what a difference a year can make for teams. For a team like the Ottawa Senators, they go from a team looking promising to a fucking mess. For the Avs, the exact opposite happened. I know the Duchene trade is an easy point to look at, but you also have to credit the emergence of Nathan MacKinnon and Mikko Rantanen for their success. To get back to the playoffs, Colorado is going to need depth to step up. It was their biggest weakness last year and their remaining question. Goaltending-wise, they got the efficient German in Philip Grubauer and Columbus grit in Ian Cole and Matt Calvert. Even if this year results in regression, there is good news afoot. The Senators are fucking idiots and you have their first-round pick. It could mean another generational talent in Jack Hughes. Is this the Lindros trade again? The Stars are in the barren saloon town known as Last Chanceville. Jim Nill and company are leaning dangerously close to the lava pit and there isn't much time to save themselves from the fires of unemployment. They've more than likely given cybernetic enhancements to Ben Bishop so he can stay healthy for most of the season and a shitload of money to Tyler Seguin. The back end has always been the weak point attacked for maximum damage, but a potential generational player in Miro Heiskanen can help with that. Let us pray that the Stars are more than one line this year. When you do coke, it's at least two. Line it up like that. You survived the horrible flames of cap hell without any significant casualties. I would be surprised, but this unfortunately means that you were strapped to an old metal pipe and couldn't do much of note this offseason. Just a few depth pickups and not much else. A team with Connor McDavid and company on it will always be in consideration for the playoff hunt, but the real piece to your success is in net. Cam Talbot needs to get back to bailing everything out for 70 games without Edmonton burning him out. And perhaps having a power play that can score more than Beavis would help. Andre Shakira will not aid you in this endeavor. Perhaps. Ever. I still believe that Chiarelli is being held for ransom in the Bahamas. It has to be why they didn't get laughed at the past few months. The old men are back in action. LA is going to surprise people and make the playoffs by everyone returning to 2014 vintage. Reverse sweeps and overtime victories will be the norm as their old team is supplemented by more old men. Imported from Russia, it's the return of the most hated man in Jersey and Ilya Kovalchuk. All of his 35-year-old goodness allowing the Kings to be locked into a really fucked cap situation for the next 2 to 3 years. Also amplified by bribing Drew Doughty to reverse jinx Vegas some more for the next 8 years. At $11 million per year? Jesus fuck, does it come with a personalized Zamboni as well? At this rate, you're going to be competing with the Arizona Cardinals for the retirement home of sports. Some people think that hell is being locked in the basement for a while. I argue that this hell is really what the Wild are experiencing. A team that was good enough to make the playoffs, but never good enough to make a lasting impression. They've willingly locked themselves into this torment, and now the time has come to pay the piper. The architect that brought in the team is gone. In comes Paul Fenton to try and do something to fix the mess. There's nothing here that screams, "Wow, this is going to put the Wild over the top." And that may be one of the most damning statements about a team. How can you be excited for a squad whose upside is as a first-round playoff exit? At least the Vikings try to hype Minnesota up before dick-punching them. There's this small part of my brain that's sticking. Not just from the forced meme that I inadvertently created, but from the feeling that the best years of the Preds window may have passed them. If it isn't, they could be ending soon. The forward core shows promise of being productive, but there are some questions for the future. The meme lord's torch could be getting passed to Yussi Saros. The defensemen are reaching their prime. Austin Watson decided to be a fucking idiot. Just like last year, the time to do something is now. The catfish won't chuck themselves onto the ice. It's the mantra of the Sharks fan. Oh well, next year will be the year we get it done. You've been saying this for a decade and a half. There comes a point where it just isn't going to happen, but by God, you aren't going to let it prevent you from trying. More massive extensions to players that may end up destroying the team when they fall out of their primes. A swan song for Jumbo Joe, and the ultimate prize. Another generational player. Eric fucking Carlson. I swear to God, if you don't make it to the cup this season, I'm going to SAP Center to flay you all and hang your skins outside of the arena. This is all but your last chance before the debt has to be paid. For the love of all that is holy, please don't fuck this up. Sticks and stones may break your bones, but being a Blues fan, that pain lasts forever. Last year emphasized these feelings. A white-hot start to the season, only for misery to be the main export as everyone got injured and the team collapsed down the stretch. And you lost your novelty as the only expansion team to make the cup. This status quo must continue. Begin the acquisition of another elite first-line center in Ryan O'Reilly. The core is interesting and shows promise, but I fear it's not going to be enough in the brutal division you're in. And there's also that goaltending situation. You need more playoff 17 Jake Allen and less of whatever the fuck last year was. Enjoy your first or second round playoff elimination, St. Louis. At least put on some lube if you're gonna fuck your fans again. Someday, the Vancouver Canucks will return to being a respectable team. Horvat and Besser will lead them to the glories of the postseason as Thatcher Demko stops everything in sight. That day will most likely not be sometime this season. The boys' club is beginning to crumble in front of our very eyes as Trevor Linden got tired of being ignored and fucked off. Jim Benning is somehow still here, getting an eternal stiffy from the wonders of North American grit and veteranosity. Here, you bottom six forwards, have a healthy payday for way too long. As Eric Goodbranson is forcing him into thinking he's viable in this new NHL, the execs are going to head to the golf course and embrace the mediocrity. You should too, Vancouver. It's the typical Vegas experience. You go down there for a weekend, have a great time, get completely smashed, blackout at the Apex. You then wake up the next morning in the middle of the desert with a massive hangover, a missing wallet, and a sore asshole. That was the Golden Knights' inaugural season. I'm supposed to feel bad that you lost a series? Welcome to the NHL. Nighttime has come early. Go and get yourselves more underappreciated talent in Paul Stastny and Max Pacioretty, who spent years being fucked over by Lord Bergevin. Do we get another Vegas jackpot this year? Or do they roll snake eyes? In another stunning turn of events, there is legitimate hope in the True North. The Jets have their first taste of success. Their young core will be getting stronger. They ponied up a lot of money to keep them around, even if guys like Blake Wheeler will bite them in the ass in 5 years. The major issue for them is getting a reliable backup goalie so Hellebuck won't turn into the next Cam Talbot and be destroyed from overuse. We kinda saw it against Vegas last year. The Central is once again going to be a bloodbath with no respite for the weak. Prepare your napalm and firebomb with extreme prejudice. The West is literally going to be a killing field, especially the Central Division. Sheer brutality and the genocide of all optimism will be the main course. As for who survives this mess in the Central, it will be Winnipeg, Nashville, Colorado, St. Louis. In the Pacific, I choose San Jose, Vegas, Edmonton, and Arizona. Yes, I think Arizona makes it, which means they aren't getting out of the basement again. I wish you all the best of luck this season. Happy brawling.
Stastny through center. Checked along the boards. Scheifele shoots wide of the net. And the puck is bouncing there. Trying to track it down. Line 8 to the front of the goal. A bouncy puck in Scheifele's feet. And it's over. And the Vegas Golden Knights will play for the Stanley Cup.